Hey there, I'm Manuela with Plytix. In this video, I'm going to explain how to connect your Plytix account to an FTP, SFTP, or a Dropbox account. Plytix has a direct integration with FTP and SFTP servers and Dropbox. Connecting these to your Plytix PIM account allows you to easily transfer data between these sources and Plytix. Once you're logged into your Plytix account, click on Settings on the top menu bar. Now, on the left menu under the General section, click on Connections. This is where you can create and manage all of your FTP, SFTP, and your Dropbox connections. Your connections will be listed in this table, along with the type of connection, the last time it was processed, the source of the connection, which refers to whether Plytix fetched information in a feed or pushed information to the connection in a channel, and whether the connection was successful or not the last time that it was processed. To create a new connection, click on Add Connection, name your connection, choose the type of connection you want to create, and click on Add Connection. This will take you to the connection's details page. If you're creating an FTP or an SFTP connection, click Edit and input the host information, which is the main URL of the website. You can also define a port if applicable and enable TLS by checking this box. Next, add the username and password and click Save Changes. To make sure the connection works, click on Test Connection. Now, if you're creating a Dropbox connection, click on Connect to Dropbox. A pop-up will appear asking you to log in to your Dropbox account. Once you've logged in, you'll need to allow the connection. You'll then see the connected email, and you can test your connection. If the connection test is successful, then you're ready to start using it in import feeds and channels. Now, once you begin using your connections, you can track them from the Usage tab. This number here refers to the number of entities being feeds or channels, where the connection is being used. In this tab, you'll see the name of the entity and the type of entity. For example, here you can see my connection is being used in a channel called Monthly Backup. For more tutorials, such as how to create an import feed, how to export data in a channel, and more, check out our help center at help.plytix.com or the YouTube playlist that I've linked in this video. I hope you find this video tutorial helpful. If you have any questions whatsoever, don't hesitate to reach out to us. If you're a Plytix user, you can email your customer success agent or reach us by chat at plytix.com.